Hello children, yesterday we have started new chapter, chapter 5, A Visitor from Fairyland. We saw how Amina was sick and Peter gave wrong medicine. The fairy came and helped Amina to recover and the conversation began between Peter and fairy. Let us continue the chapter. Fairy, your house is near a busy street. Continuous intake of polluted air has choked her. That's why she has a headache. But Peter, you also have done wrong thing. You have given her a tablet. It was not for children. Doctor had given it for your mother. Peter, I am sorry. I did it in haste. Fairy, don't do this again. Always take medicine with a direction from your elders. Fairy touches Amina again with her stick and Amina gets up, fresh and cheerful. Peter, you are so kind. Let us be friends. Fairy, that's all right. But we don't like to come to cities. Cities will turn us into fiends. We only come to help good children when they are in trouble. My friends are living near the brooks that have clear and pure water. So here we see fairy is asking Peter the reason why Amina became unconscious. He was not knowing the reason why. Then fairy started to explain to him, because your house is near a busy street. So, continually inhaling the polluted air has made her the difficulty in breathing. That's why she had a headache. But Peter, she said, you also have done wrong in giving her the tablet, which was for your mother, not for your children. So, what Peter did, he understood the mistake and asked sorry from fairy. Then the fairy told to him that always take the medicine with the direction from your elders. So again, what fairy did, she touches Amina with her stick and Amina got up. So Peter told to fairy, you helped us in need. Let us be friends. So the children requested fairy to stay with them. But she refused, telling that cities would turn us into evils. We come only to help the good children. Again, fairy told them that her friends were living near the brooks. The meaning of brooks is a small river. Amina, thank you, fairy. You are welcome, Amina. Have chocolates. Fairy stretches her hand and she gets chocolates in her hand. She gives them to both the children. My dear children, when you grow up, you shouldn't cut trees. Don't kill animals and don't hurt any creature on the earth. Let the earth be green and beautiful. Amina, yes, fairy, we will keep it in mind. Peter, but will you take us one day to the fairyland? We have only heard about it in stories. Fairy, no, but I'll visit you again. Bye bye. Fairy vanished. So here we see fairy giving a chocolate to both of them. Do you remember, children? What are the advice fairy gave to the children? The advice are, don't cut trees, don't kill animals, don't hurt any creatures on earth. Let the earth be green and beautiful. So the children have agreed all that what she said. Again fairy said to them, I'll visit you again, and then she vanished from there. So children, what have you learned from this lesson? What is the moral of the lesson? The moral of the lesson is, whenever you are alone in the absence of your parents and the elders, never do any mischievous things. Always take the medicine with the direction of your parents, and also take care of the nature. Thank you. So dear children, your homework is, go through the lesson, read it again, find out the difficult meanings, words and its meaning, and also learn the word power.